There's a couple different ways to number six. So we'll do both ways. I like number six, let's see.
You would.
Alright, so let me try to start catching up to you guys. So, number two especially is one that you should not have to use USUB, but I'll show you USUB works on that also. Right. Number one, you could probably do that without USUB, but it certainly makes it a lot easier to mess with. So what would I let you be in number one here? Who is it? I don't want to let it equal 1 minus x squared, because the derivative of that won't be in there, right? So if I did try to let it equal 1 minus 3x squared, its derivative would be 2 times 1 minus 3x times negative 3, and that's not in there, right? So you would actually be what? Just 1 minus 3x. So Marshall, I don't blame you for doing that, because that's like stuck on the bottom, right? But then it's even more inside is what I need, because if I try to make it this squared, the derivative is just not in there. So that's immediately I see that's a wrong choice. This is what I mean by it's part of the process to make mistakes sometimes, which is fine. It's not a damn thing wrong with it. You just go, oh shit, maybe it's even more internal. There's another nested doll inside, and it's the 1 minus 3x. So what's du? Negative 3dx, kick ass. So then I can write this as, what do I need in here that's not in it?
Negative 3.
So if I put a negative 3, I better put a negative 1/3 on the outside. So overall, I just didn't do anything. Yeah. Alright, so now I can write this as negative 1/3. What is negative 3dx?
Du.
And I can write the bottom as
u squared.
U squared. Now, how do you integrate 1 over u squared? U to the negative 2, right? So how do you integrate that?
Just that
root
to the power.
Sure. So the u to the negative 1 divided by
negative 1.
Negative 1. Is that cool? What's up? You guys? No? Okay.
You can change.
So I can rewrite this as, let me put the integral in there. I can write this as negative 1/3 integral u to the negative 2 du. So it looks more like the power rule. So this will be negative 1/3. How do you integrate something u to the power of a number? It would be u to the negative 2 plus 1 divided by that new power. Stop there. And so what happens there? The negatives
cancel.
So you get 1/3. What was u?
1 minus 3x.
And you could also write that as 1 over 3 times 1 minus 3x. You can bring it down to the bottom. Either way is fine. Okay.
Sure. I just should add something.
Well, we'll see. Alright. And real quick. I'm not going to do it. Number two, I said if you use u sub, I can let u be 3x plus 2. Then what's du? 3dx. So I'm missing a 3. So again, I kind of made this the same for purpose. I could put a 3 on the inside as long as it's a 1/3 on the outside. Is everybody cool with what I just did? Is everybody alright with that? Don't just go, I'm sure it's fine, Jeff. You know this shit. Do you understand what I just did and why I just did it? I need a 3dx. So I put a 3 inside, but I can't just do that. That'd be great if I could. Holy shit, every problem would be easy. I don't like that 2 then. You put it somewhere. No. But so at the same time, I better balance myself out. So I put a 1/3 on the outside. So it'd be 1/3. 3dx is. How are we doing? You alright? 3dx is du, and this is secant squared of u. And what's the integral of secant squared? Tangent, and what was U?
3x plus 8.
Now, again, like a very good question somebody asked, did you have to use U7 on that? Hell no. The angle of the secant squared is tangent of this. I need an over 3 to kill the 3 that wants to come out. I taught it that way first, specifically, so it would make sense why U-sub works. It kind of does what we just did. It just kind of makes it happen. It put that 1/3 there to kill the 3 that wants to come out. You can kind of see it. I like it. So if you see that, you don't have to use U-sub. Dear God. Number 3 is kind of in your face. Which one's definitely the inside function? Uh-oh, maybe it's not in your face. Why is cotangent inside function? Because it's inside, square root, right? So that's where I start first. If I don't see a function that's like inside, or if the inside function doesn't have a derivative in there, maybe u is something else. Sort of like that 1 over x natural log of x one that we had, right? You have to be careful. Well, I need the function whose derivative is in there. So I have a couple options for u. I've got to figure out what it is. Here, there's really only one thing. U is cotangent x, and its derivative is what?
Negative cosecant squared.
Negative cosecant squared. Cool. I like it. So obviously, if you have any trouble with your derivatives, integrals are not going to work for you. Right, you got to know your derivatives to be able to do this. So what's kind of missing that's really easy to take care of?
A negative.
Negative. So that becomes negative integral, square root of
u.
So let me write that as u to 1 half. And then this du. And now I can focus all my attention on this. I don't have to try to bring stuff back in from this because it's all in there. This represents this. They're the same thing. If u is cotangent x, which it is, because we said so. Now. So then when I integrate u to the 1 half?
U to the 3 over 2.
Yeah, u to the 3 over 2.
2/3.
2/3. And what was u?
Cotangent x. Plus
u. Sorry, I didn't do it for purpose. It was a good reveal. I like that. Yes, no, maybe? I mean, once you do that u substitution and you rewrite the integral and there's no x's left, that's a really good indication you're on the right track. And then you forget for a minute what that was. You just focus on what it is. Don't try to bring that x track back in until you're done. You don't have to, thank God. What about number 4? I like number 4. What's the good option for an inside function?
X.
Yeah, it's like inside 1 over blank. Right? So if you let u equal, and no, I don't know why I said blank like that. What's du?
2x plus 6.
Is that in there? 2x plus 6 dx, right? Is that in there?
No. Just take out the 2.
Well, I don't have a 2 to take out. I need to put a 2 in, right? If I put a 2 in, that would be 2x plus 6. But to make it legal, I got to put a 1/2 out front. I like it. Please make that understand. So if the tutors try to show you that other way where you solve for dx, tell them, don't give me that shit. Don't give it to me. I want to know the way that actually keeps in mind what the hell's truly going on. One of my central themes with math is we're making these processes that make it easier. Sure, it makes it easier, but then you lose touch with why it works. And you try to do stuff you're not allowed to do. Anyway, sorry. It's a bitter point for me. So then you get 1/2. What is 2x plus 6dx?
Du.
And then x squared plus 6x is u. So what's the integral of 1 over u?
L over u.
Yeah, look at me right in. Ln of, and u was x squared plus 6x. Kabam. Oh, and it's got limits. I'm with you. So I would have done this like this. But again, if you don't want to, you could change the limits. You could plug a 1 in, you could plug a 3 in and see what u would be. Personally, I just like to do this. I don't need the plus c then, do I? So now I just do what? Plug my 3 in, plug my 1 in. I like it.
Isn't that literally the exact same amount of work?
Yes. The only difference, though, the truly only difference from a pedagogical standpoint is, if there are no limits, I have to bring back X anyway. So it's kind of nice to get extra practice doing that. That's the only thing that, as a teacher, makes me want to teach this way more. But like I said, also in Calc 3, you have to get used to working with the limits directly. So I don't mind if you do that either. It's okay. What time is it? Oh yeah, we're about out of time. So we'll finish this one up next time. Sorry, John. I'll ask you questions next time.
I think it's 7:20.
I don't know yet. I just need to break for class.
It's like,
yeah, because then you make the bottom a single turn and then you can break it up.
Yeah.
Well, wait a minute.
I like this.
Yeah,
it's a lot of clear for you.
Exactly. Now watch the
thing you use for
your mind. What would be n minus 2 plus 7?
Yeah.
Over n minus 2.
Yeah, but then
it's not that. Then it would be 1 plus 7 over n minus 2.
Because
you're just sort of like what the U7 does. It brings that
form
in it, right? Yeah. So that's another way to do it without a U7. But U7 kind of does the same thing.
That's a way around like partial fractions and stuff like that, yeah.
Eyeballing.